I was recently asked to fix a friend's mom's computer because it's riddled with viruses. It's running Windows Vista. It's kind of old, and so I thought the best solution would be to install some form of Linux. And I'm going to try Ubuntu. I haven't used it in a while. I'm just going to take you through that process. Go to the site. Going to get Ubuntu Desktop 12.04 long-term support. The infected computer has a Turion, an AMD Turion processor. It's a 64-bit processor. I'm going to get the 64-bit version and start download. Notice it's an ISO.ISO. I'm just going to save the file. 694 megabytes. I got a DVD out. I could just use a CD for that. I'm gonna get one. It's gonna take a few minutes, so I will come back when it's done. The download is complete. I'm going to insert a CDR. Just gonna close out of this. So now I'll just open up CD Burner XP. I want to burn an ISO image. Okay. Target device, that is my drive. I'm gonna browse for the image. It's gonna be on the downloads. There's that. Hit open. Oh, this looks fine. Burn disk. This will take a few minutes. Okay. Now we take it to the laptop and install. This is the infected computer. I'm going to take this disk, put it in the optical drive, restart this computer, and try to get into the BIOS. I'm going to do that by tapping one of the function keys, F2, F8, F10, maybe. It's different for every computer. This is a Toshiba Satellite A215 and some other numbers after that. You could probably just Google the appropriate key for this laptop. I didn't do it, so I'm just gonna tap. Could be delete as well, at least on most of the motherboards that I build computers with. It's usually delete. Just tapping these buttons. I'm gonna start with F2. Okay, it says please wait. I don't know what it's doing, I didn't have time to read. Here we go. Now, we need to tell it to boot from the disk. Okay, looks like the first device is the hard drive. We need to change it to that. Keys used to view or configure devices. Up and down arrow select device. F5 and F6 move the device. F6. Okay. F6 is up, I guess. We will save changes and exit. Save configuration changes and exit now. Yes. Should say, you want to boot from the disk, hit any key. Or it might just go into it. It's going into it. It should give you the option to either install alongside your current operating system or erase it entirely and start fresh with Ubuntu. We're going to choose the latter because that Windows Vista is shot. Here's the choice: try it or install. I'm going to install. Have to get a long Cat 6 cable and plug it in. And this thing just kicked up when I plugged that in. Okay. Here we go. Download updates while installing. I am not gonna mess with this right now. This extra software that they have built in because I don't know what they're using. Continue. It recognizes that Vista's on there. So install Ubuntu alongside Windows Vista, and it'll prompt you when the computer starts. It'll have a big list of different versions of Ubuntu installed that you could start with, like a safe mode, like a whatever. Replace Windows Vista with Ubuntu, so that'll delete everything. Or we can create or resize partitions. I guess theoretically we could create multiple partitions through this installer and install a number of operating systems like Windows 7, and Windows 8 is about to come out in like a month. I'm just gonna replace Windows Vista with Ubuntu. Continue. And that is the only choice. I guess if there were other drives, this being a laptop, I'm not surprised there's only one drive, the entire disk will be used. Two partitions will be deleted, so it's the two that are created when you install Windows. Or I guess since this is a pre-built computer, perhaps their recovery partition, they have a separate partition that's hidden. I don't know. It's deleting both though, so that's fine. Install now. I want to kill everything on the hard drive and a fresh install of Ubuntu. Time zone. I am on the East Coast, so New York will do. I speak English, I type English. It's all good. Name. The name of the person using this will be Susan, so S-U-S-A-N. That works. Wow, it knew the model and everything. That's cool. Username will be Susan. I don't know if back in the day you couldn't capitalize this. I'm gonna see if I can. Yeah, must start with a lowercase. I don't know why that is. Whatever. Choose a password. It's weak, but it's long enough. Require my password to log in. That's the way she had Windows Vista set up, so might as well. I'm not going to worry about encrypting her home folder. It's going to tell us about it. Ubuntu has an app store, photo manager, 5 gigabytes of cloud storage, media player, messaging client, I guess. Is that something about Facebook and Twitter? Okay, Firefox is the default browser, LibreOffice. Biggie, don't step on that keyboard. Don't do it. It's asking us to restart because installation is complete. Restart. This process could go faster or slower depending on your hardware. This is kind of an old laptop, so it has taken quite a bit of time. It ejected the disk. I'm taking it out, closing, and then hitting enter. So now I should just boot straight into it. I'll need to go back and tell it to boot from the hard drive after this to get back in the BIOS. Wonder if that's the go button. I'm gonna hit back. That's not the go button. It's arrow, perhaps. You probably hit enter. I just wanted to see what that Ubuntu symbol did. Okay. Looks like we are in. This kind of looks like a mixture of OS X and Windows 7. Or any Windows. I put my taskbar on the left, and that's what they've done here. So there's the dash home. I guess that's the start button. Kinda. There's your folder of documents and such. Web browser. Here's your office applications. And there's the App Store. Ubuntu One, I believe that was the cloud storage thing. System settings, that's like the control panel or something. Or on OS X, I guess that's system preferences. Workspace switcher. Okay, update manager is automatically starting. Because I didn't hit it. 65 updates have been selected. Sure. Alright, so I'm not seeing a Wi-Fi icon up here. Yeah, anyway, now that that's started. The OS X version of this, well, I guess that kind of looks like the dock, but the dock is kind of like the taskbar anyway. But this top bar here, that is right out of OS X. Yeah, I don't care about this. I was wanting a list of those updates it found. I was going to see if it had the wireless drivers for this laptop. Maybe it's in there, it's just not showing because it's plugged in, it's wired. Probably have to restart after these. Huh. It's kind of a delay, but I'm controlling that with a little dial down here in the front of the, like the physical dial. Just wanted to see if it would work, and it does, that's nice. Can't really do many things simultaneously on here. I'm going to attribute that to the 1 gigabyte of DDR2 SD RAM inside this thing. That should probably be upgraded, if you can still find any. Yeah, man, this looks just like OS X. Maybe I could just right-click the background. I want to change the resolution or just see what the resolution is. Okay, the updates are complete. I'll restart. I guess in the meantime, while restarting, I'll change it back to boot from the hard drive. Yeah, it said down here, hit F2 to go to setup. Now go back to boot. I guess F5 is down, so I will push that. down. The top one is booting first. Now go to exit. Exit saving changes, hit enter, save configurations, and exit now, yes. Because that's their startup sound or some African drums. I think Ubuntu is an African word. This is running a lot smoother and booting a lot faster than it ever was with that Windows Vista on there. That's just too big an operating system for this hardware. Go over here and see what this is now. Okay. Displays. There we go. I guess 1280 by 800 is the native resolution. I guess that would say update if it didn't say software up to date. No updates to install, so this is the most updated thing. Now I'm going to unplug this Ethernet cable. See if I can set this up wirelessly. And there's a Wi-Fi symbol, at least outline of it. Looks like it's trying to connect. Connection established. Okay. The end. Ubuntu is installed.